As the night began to dawn upon us, eyes would begin to close, and millions of stars would shine brightly upon the black canvas of the night sky. Lights would fade away, and the moon would illuminate the city of peaceful Homo sapiens, breathing rhythmically to the sound of the crickets and the rustling of leaves as the cold wind blows. But some of us choose to be rats of the night, who roamed the streets, moving like vicious wolves. Their spray can are their weapons, their mind are their inspirations. The streets are the playground, and the walls are their canvases.
I think graffiti is a very expressive form of art. It's by far the coolest element of hip-hop because writers are able to project what they think or feel into their pieces or on their canvases. I also think graffiti is like warfare between the crews because they mark their territories with their tags and they win wars through competition. So basically I respect all the talented writers like AMC and TFB, OAC, and they should do what they do and be good at it.
Graffiti in Singapore, how should I put this? Okay, to put it simply, graph writers in Singapore, well, some are very talented, some are not. The really, really talented ones, yeah, I'm very, very impressed with them.
Graffiti in Singapore also, I don't think they can go quite high because there are still not enough people to bring up this underground graffiti thingy. So I hope that more people will go in, but they won't stop halfway and hope they go in because of passion.
I got my tag name, started a long way. In school, such a slacker that my teacher called me slacker because I like to sleep actually. So from there, when I start to bomb, I start to use slacker as my tag name. But after a while, I cut it down to just slack. Started in 1998, until now, I think around 8 years. My shades. We're doing illegal bombing starting from late 1998 until finally we were caught in the year 2000 at Sungai FMP Pasir Ris. From there, it was all hell. I mean, go up and down from court, flight. Then after appeal and we fight the case actually by a lawyer, and then the vandalism charge is brought down to mischievous act. So we got into probation for 1 year, and from there we did a lot of projects as a legal artist from MCDS. Doing graffiti like every day. Every day is a graffiti day for me. I love to sketch every day. And it's like my mindset is, last time we tend to do illegal bombing. It's like we always mark out the plan from where we want to bomb, what time. So it's very close. It's like actually it's like in my blood already. It's my passion. Actually, this is my latest style. I think I'm more into 3D abstract with a blend of Y style in it. I don't really like to fix my style just to for the sake of having a style, but I like to evolve my style in a way of people will tend to see my graffiti piece or production in an evolving kind of way. I mean, I don't like to stick to just one style. Sinaiku was basically formed in my ITE days in my studio with my buddy Mom. The two of us, the co-founder of Zignite Crew, in which we got the name also spontaneously, so Zignite Crew, so we cut it short to ZNC, and then from there, it all started in 1998 in a studio. Long-term dream is to get more legal roles for the scene in Singapore, and I would like to be one of the few people who can educate the street people, I mean the community, about what is graffiti is all about. I mean, I want to tell them that graffiti is not all vandals. I mean, graffiti can be in the same level with fine arts and all art form that exists. I mean, it's like, but the main important thing for me is to fight for more legal laws. Basically, importantly, in the streets. So, I think that's all.